Hello friends, hope everything is fine with you guys. Now in this lecture, we are going to design a bus logo. Yes, friend. So let's create a new document. Now let's select the rounded rectangle tool. And oh my God, its radius is really high, right? So let's delete it. And let's come here, click at a point. Corner radius, let's make it say 20 point. And now let's click on OK. Let's make its fill color black. And let's reduce its size a little bit. Reduce its height a little bit, just like this. And now select the ellipse tool and draw a circle around here. Now make sure that you have selected this object, this circle. Alt drag to make a copy of it and hold the shift key to move it in parallel fashion and just bring it here. Yep, okay. Yep, this looks kind of fine, isn't it? Or does it? Yep, okay. Now let's select all of these three objects. And now click on trim. Now select the direct selection tool. Select these two and move it down. Not too much. Just like this. And see, you have designed a bus logo. That's cool, right? And let's oh my God, what happened? Let's press Ctrl Z. Now to make it a perfect bus logo, one simple trick which you can do is, I don't know, I think you may not get it now clearly, but you can move this anchor point. Press Ctrl Z. Select the direct selection tool. Only select this point and using the left key, just, oh my God, press Ctrl Z. Okay. Now select the direct selection tool, zoom in a little bit to work more efficiently. Make sure that using the direct selection tool you have selected this anchor point, right? And just move it like this. So means I'm just doing it to make it a perfect bus logo. If you are not understanding it, that how I am doing it, don't bother it about now, because later we'll be having detailed class or detailed lectures, you can say, on this anchor points, pin tool, all of this stuff. So don't worry about it now. Similarly, select the direct selection tool, select only this anchor point and move it using the arrow keys. Yes, friend. Now similarly, you can do that here also. Only select the anchor point and move it. Select the anchor point and move it. That's it. That's it. Now see, it's a perfect bus logo, isn't it? Okay. And now let's select the selection tool. Let me shrink it a bit to make it a logo size. You can even say that it's an icon, right? Yup, we can say that it's an icon. Okay. It's really fun, right, working with Illustrator? Now using the type tool, let's write here, transport. Let's make it around 60 points. And I'm thinking, to make this a colorful bus of green color. Is it looking nice? We have applied styles. Yep, let's make it like this. Then we have this transport character. Let's make it this one. Yep. Transport. Using the type tool, let me make it all caps. Even you can go to object, expand the text. Let's select this O using direct selection tool. This O, and oops. Let me zoom in. Yup. You can change its color to something else. You can even provide a circle kind of stuff here. Yup. And select these circles and let's make it this color. What do you think? Just for fun, right? Yeah, yep. I think this is looking perfect. So that's it, guys. Well, let me save it as logo 4. Okay, so that's it, guys. So till now we have designed 4 logos. This is our first logo, the bricks logo. Then the second logo, Roshni. Then the third logo, our Pac-Man logo. Then the fourth logo, the bus logo, or the transport logo, you can say. And even if you think, if you can notice that these can also be treated as icons, isn't it? Yeah, even icons can also be designed in Illustrator. Okay, so that's it, guys. Here I'm concluding this project. In our next project, we are going to design a very cool logo. Yes, friend. And we are going to design this logo. Yes, friend. So let's see how we are going to do that. So see you in the next project. Till then, have fun. Take care.